He is the way, the truth, and the life. No man, come on, help me, comes unto the Father but by him. In the name of Jesus, get up and walk. Ladies and gentlemen, he got up. He got up. And he started leaping and praising God. The arms work. The legs work. I don't have to beg anymore. I'm not trapped in this spot. I don't have to be carried anymore. And he got up and ran into the temple. And everyone that was praying to God saw the paralyzed man. And he's walking and great joy broke out. I wonder if there's any joy in this place right now. Is there any joy in this place? So the heads of the five families, Caiaphas, Annas, Alexander, and the other two said, arrest them, bring them in front of us. And they tried to turn an act of mercy and miraculous power into a crime. That's what's going on now. And you know what they said? I want you to watch this. I'm going to read Acts chapter 4, verse 16 very quickly. What shall we do to these men? For indeed, a notable miracle has been done through them. And it's evident to all who dwell in Jerusalem. Let's rehearse this. Everyone in town knew that a miracle that was incurable and undeniable had just happened. How many of you believe that in Roseville, California, we need miracles that are undeniable to start happening? How many of you believe? No, I want to know. How many of you believe it? Now, the Bible says, and I want you to picture anybody else, any human being, the most hardened atheist, still has a molecule of compassion for his fellow man. But these guys were the embodiment of evil. And it says this, what shall we do to these men? For indeed a notable miracle has been done through them that is evident to all that dwell in Jerusalem. And we cannot deny it. Now, what would you think the next phrase would be for the mayor of this city or the governor of this state or somebody else? What do you think their statement would be? What would a decent human being who's gone through a pandemic, who's watched death and destruction, we in California that have watched our children die and our families blown apart by fentanyl and gang violence and criminal activity. Here's a cure. Here's a cure. The vaccine isn't one, but this is. Now look. I'm going to keep going before I get banned on this social media. Now, I'm looking at you and I'm telling you, something good happened here. Something good. I would love to be around among those guys and say, look, somebody who was paralyzed is perfectly whole. And we can't deny it. This means that we ought to bring Peter in here and let him pray for everybody. We ought to let the Christian church get up. Hey, Christian, get in our school. Hey, Christian, get in our club. Get in our society. Let's get everyone off of drugs. But no. Their next phrase is beyond comprehension. It says in verse 17 that it spreads no further. Now, let me tell you, that's not just evil. That is stupid. Look at me, that's stupid. Kind of like some of the stupidity we've seen in the last week. That's stupid. To say this man by the power of God made a man walk and we think we can stop it. And then it said, in order to stop them, let's threaten them. Let's severely threaten them that from now on they speak to no one in this name. Now I'm going to stop and I'm going to tell you that what I'm preaching tonight has two parts. This is part one. Part two is going to happen after the altar call. I'm going to look at you and I'm going to tell you, they wanted to keep a lie alive. They're trying to hold on to a lie. We know, for example, that there is no modern example of people lying on this level against Jesus. Do you know that right now, if you add it all up, a government drug program produces about a 7% cure. When you add the baptism of the Holy Spirit to a drug program, the cure goes up over 80%. Now, look at me. If I were to walk into Gavin Newsom's office today and say, we have fentanyl addiction all over California. What you need to do is let every preacher that's spirit-filled go into every high school and every junior high and stand up there in an assembly and say, come to Christ and get filled with the Spirit and your heroin addiction will go away and your fentanyl addiction will go away. You know what? I got an email today where somebody slammed me and they said, if what you taught was real, you could go into a hospital and empty it. And I answered him and said, no, because the hospitals are against what I'm preaching. Now, I would love the opportunity to see if America would wake up and realize that it was Jesus that made us great. And it was Jesus that made us happy. And it was Jesus that, I'm waiting on you now. And it was Christ that kept our families together and kept us safe. And wherever the gospel is, man, I'm gonna say it. Wherever the gospel is preached, there's power over addiction. There's power over suicide. There's power. Why won't you let us tell America? Somebody's lying to you.